The Juggernaut is seen as a very powerful character in the Marvel Universe. Some stories even say that once he has built up enough momentum, nothing can stop the Juggernaut. But what about Thor? Could he stop the Juggernaut? And how would his legendary hammer, Mjolnir, fare up against him? There's actually a few stories about Thor going up against Juggernaut. This video will cover three separate stories when these two characters battled each other. The first encounter we can look at is from Thor issue 411. It starts off with Eric Masterson and Hercules watching the latest news. A security installation on Avengers Island was attacked and destroyed. Eric has a feeling that something is happening out there. It's like every superhero and his brother was attacked in the last 24 hours. He thinks that someone is declaring total war on them, but who would do this? A mysterious man is shown to be in search of Thor, but he cannot find him. He was able to find Hercules and this human that's associated with the Avengers. He's got something planned for Thor. We then see that Juggernaut is being held within a British maximum security prison at Crossmoor. He's one of the strongest beings on the planet, but is held in place by a special stasis cage. Then suddenly, a flash of light occurs in Juggernaut's holding cell. When it clears up, it seems like the Juggernaut has simply vanished, and is later seen to appear in New York. He thinks he was brought here for a reason, so he starts causing havoc in the city as he walks around. Eric sees the Juggernaut on the news. Normally, the X-Factor team would handle the Juggernaut, but there's no time to be territorial. He also plans to leave Hercules behind, as he can do things faster on his own. With one tap of his enchanted cane on the ground, he transforms into the mighty Thor. The mysterious man also wonders how Thor suddenly appeared. He does not know where Thor was hiding all this time. Now we get to the part where Thor meets up with Juggernaut and offers him a chance to surrender. But with a single swipe, Juggernaut swats Thor and it sends him flying back, smashing into a building. As he recovers, Thor flies around looking for Juggernaut and a car is thrown towards him in the air. But Thor is able to smash it and make it land in a safe spot. If that's not enough, Juggernaut then tosses a bus loaded with innocent people. By swinging his hammer, Thor creates a tornado and safely places the bus down on a nearby roof. Thor suddenly starts to feel some unexpected weakness. It could be from the strain caused by intense concentration or momentary seizures that he goes through ever since he's been on Earth. As Thor is going after Juggernaut, he's being watched by Richard Rider, and he notices Thor's in pretty bad shape. He might need some assistance during this matter, so this person contacts a few people that could help. The battle continues on Long Island. Juggernaut tosses a boxcar as Thor catches it. He can feel his strength is fading. Thor tries to gather his strength before Juggernaut notices how weak he's getting over time. Juggernaut continues to taunt Thor, saying that he's outmatched and does not know when to quit. Juggernaut then pushes another boxcar and slams it into Thor. From underneath the rubble, Thor punches outward and hits Juggernaut. As Juggernaut rises from the rubble, he says that shot did not even hurt him, and nothing can. Thor even tries to use his hammer on Juggernaut. He spins it around, then tosses it away. But what happens next is very unexpected. Juggernaut says he has a personal force field around his body, which ends up slowing down the momentum of Mjolnir up to a point where it just stops in front of Juggernaut, and he says that nothing can hurt him. As Thor's hammer turns around, it starts to return to Thor's hand. This is when Juggernaut holds onto it and flies towards Thor. As Juggernaut smashes into Thor, the impact sends Thor flying backwards, smashing through vehicles and into a building. It seems like Thor is outmatched. As Juggernaut prepares his final attack, a blast of energy comes his way. A group of heroes comes to the rescue. They are Marvel Boy, Nova, Namorita, the Night Thrasher, Firestar, and Speedball, calling themselves the New Warriors. I also want to point out that during this story, you'll notice there are parts where they call Juggernaut a mutant, which is not really accurate because he does not have a mutant gene in his body. If you know about his origin story, his powers were originally from the magical gem of Sitarak. The story continues in Thor, issue 412. This time, it's a full team of heroes against the Juggernaut. As a few members try to fight Juggernaut, they can't do enough to stop him or to even hold him in place. All they could do is buy Thor enough time to recover. That mysterious man brings up an image of what's happening. He's disappointed that some heroes got in the way of his plan. If they didn't interfere, Juggernaut would have completed his mission to humiliate Thor. But still, the other phases of his grand scheme are all proceeding as planned. The heroes even try to smash two boxcars on the Juggernaut. This huge amount of weight falls onto the villain, but it's not enough. Juggernaut suddenly frees himself from a mountain of debris with a seemingly effortless shrug. The battle then shifts over to a construction site. Our heroes are trying to slow Juggernaut, but it's no use. Even when Firestar uses her microwave attack to heat Juggernaut's body, it has almost no effect. She's even told to aim for Juggernaut's heart, but she refuses. She will not take someone's life. Thor would show up and try another attack on Juggernaut. He slams the hammer on the ground to summon a bolt of lightning. It strikes Juggernaut directly, but mere seconds later, it had no effect. The Juggernaut continues to move forward. Thor is then forced to use one of his most powerful attacks, something that he once used on Galactus, and it even gave pause to an almighty celestial, a blast so powerful that it starts to push the Juggernaut backwards. The foundation below him starts to crumble. He falls into a hole, and the heroes place steel girders inside. Firestar then burns them enough until it becomes a molten slag. Thor's hammer then summons a frigid wind to harden the object. It won't take long for the Juggernaut to escape, so Thor opens a portal of time and space, then banishes the obelisk to some distant dimension. Juggernaut breaks free, but does not know where he is. Regardless, he vows to find his way home and take his revenge on Thor. Even though the Juggernaut had failed, the mysterious man says Thor and the Avengers are destined to perish as a result of his acts of vengeance. Thor would speak to the New Warriors and ask why they gathered here. Their goal is to help in the war on crime. They are young, but they have much to learn about honor and nobility. Thor flies off and says, the world will soon marvel at the stirring exploits of the New Warriors. Within issue 413 of Thor, we find out what's causing Thor to lose his strength. During a meeting with Doctor Strange, they're able to go into Thor's subconscious mind, and they encounter a nightmarish version of Thor covered in his battle armor. This is the cause of his seizures. It's draining his strength, leeching his powers, sapping his resolve. Thor eventually wins the battle and removes the mask of the imposter, only to reveal it's actually Loki. This happened during the War of the Gods, when Thor was bereft of his powers. Loki secretly lent him some of his. Now they are engaged in a much more interesting war. Believing that the exorcism had worked on him to remove Loki from his mind, Thor says he will be in debt to Doctor Strange. He flies off to find the other Avengers to warn them of Loki. Near the end of Thor issue 428, the British government sends out a team to find Juggernaut, to figure out how he escaped his holding cell and ended up in New York. Thor offers to take them to the asteroid where he sent the Juggernaut. The group arrives on the asteroid, but they don't see any signs of life. Thor flips his hammer and tries to locate the Juggernaut, but the area they're standing on seems a bit strange. It's been previously camouflaged. A second later, the group gets zapped by a depolarizer attack and are knocked out. As each hero is placed within an unbreakable prison sphere, one member was still conscious, but she pretends to be knocked out, so she doesn't endanger the others. When our heroes fully awaken, they find themselves the attraction of a big crowd within a city. They are brought towards a large structure, and there they meet someone Thor cannot believe who it is. It's the Juggernaut. This world belongs to him. He is seen as the master and the absolute law. This time, our heroes are seen as the criminals. During the comic of Thor, issue 429, we get to see the rematch between Thor and Juggernaut. Thor's intentions were to get rid of Juggernaut by putting him on an asteroid, but a passing ship picked up Juggernaut, and then he took over this place that was run by another prince. A group of armed men shows up and starts to fire upon some guards. They are followers of Prince Zalaski. They say that if these strangers are enemies of the Juggernaut, then they are friends of ours. Friends who will surely help us regain my kingdom. Prince Zalaski offers Thor a deal. If he joins his cause to get rid of Juggernaut, the prince will release the other heroes. Even though Zalaski is not liked by the people, he is the rightful ruler of this world. Thor gives his word to not challenge the prince afterwards, and he flies off in search of the Juggernaut. Thor shows up and offers Juggernaut a chance to give up the kingdom he took over and return Thor back to Earth. But knowing Juggernaut, he's not giving up without a fight. The other heroes are able to escape by holding hands and becoming intangible through one person's powers. They're able to walk through the spheres that hold them. They knock out the single guard and try to find Thor. During his battle against the Juggernaut, Thor uses his hammer to unleash a beam of energy at Juggernaut. Its true purpose was to reveal the source of Juggernaut's powers, which are magical. Thor then tosses his hammer outside an open window, just missing Juggernaut. But this was intentional. It spins around the castle very quickly. This effect will negate all mystical energy within this area. This means that Juggernaut is no longer protected by an impenetrable force field. Thor hits Juggernaut so hard that his helmet gets torn off, but Thor only has around 60 seconds to stop Juggernaut. His hammer needs to return to his hand, or he will revert back to his human form of Eric Masterson. Juggernaut may have lost his invulnerability, but he still retains his super strength, which he uses to batter Thor. But the Thunder God has had enough. He unleashes his own set of attacks on the enemy. Juggernaut is dazed and staggering, but refuses to give up. Thor throws one more punch, but in that split second, Juggernaut's force field returns. This is when Thor's hammer also comes back to his hand, just before the 60th second. Juggernaut notices that the hammer is the source of Thor's power. If there was a way to get his hands on it, he would be unbeatable and unstoppable. Juggernaut attacks with a giant pillar. The impact makes Thor drop his hammer. Now is his chance to grab it. Juggernaut reaches out, holds onto Mjolnir, and tries to lift it, but he can't. He doesn't understand why. He easily has more strength than Thor, but is unable to pick up the hammer. Thor tells him it can only be lifted by someone who is truly worthy of its ageless power. Thor begins to spin his hammer very quickly. As Juggernaut throws a punch, his wrist is wrapped within the unbreakable bond. Juggernaut is unable to break free as the hammer flies off into deep space, taking Juggernaut far away from here. The people within the palace start to emerge. They realize their master is now gone, but they still fear being ruled by Zalaski. Thor remains silent as he gave his word to Zalaski to not speak against him. When he threw his hammer into the deepest part of space, more than 60 seconds will pass before it returns, and so he transforms back to Eric Masterson. In this human form, he then speaks to the people of this land. They don't have to fear Zalaski. He tells them that this is their land. You are the true masters of it. All they have to do is band together. As our heroes prepare to find a way back to Earth, Mjolnir returns to the hand of Eric, which transforms him back to Thor. It's up to the people of this planet to make their own decisions on who will rule it. And as for Juggernaut, he's presently lost in the vast terrain of deep space. To him, this is only a minor setback. He will try to find a way back to Earth. The rest of that story branches off into a different direction with other comic books, but that pretty much covers the battle between Thor and Juggernaut for this story. Another time Thor fought against the Juggernaut was during the comic book titled The Eighth Day. This story once again takes place in New York. Thor's body falls to the ground, smashing with a heavy impact. He was attacked by a being known as Enracht. Thor attempts to throw his hammer at this enemy, but is surprised when Enracht is able to stop the hammer, hold it in his hands, then throw it back. Enracht would prepare to teleport away to see Thor's father breathe his last breath. Thor tries to follow him, but his attention is then diverted away. He looks down to the street. Local police are shooting at something, and amongst the rubble, Juggernaut emerges. No matter how desperately Odin needed his son's help, he would understand. Thor chooses to stay behind to save the mortals of this realm. He rushes in to attack Juggernaut, and using Mjolnir, he lands multiple blows on the enemy, but it seems to do nothing. All that happens is the ground starts to tremble. Thor is then trapped in the Juggernaut's grip. He feels that he cannot match the strength of this giant brute. Juggernaut's eyes show he has lost all his sense and sanity. Thor's body then gets smashed into a nearby wall, his body left on the ground as Juggernaut walks away. Thor wonders, how can he get enough power to defeat someone so strong? We then get a glimpse of Loki, who's watching everything. He also knows the origins of Juggernaut's powers. Loki is also familiar with the name Sitarak. It's been a long time since he heard that name. Loki mentions that two other people had a similar story like the Juggernaut. In Northern Ireland, a young woman finds the Kestrel Key of Crakan, and she transforms into Conquest, the living embodiment of battle. And over in Kenya, a woman finds the ivory idol of Ikon. It turns her into Bedlam, avatar of mind and madness. Thor would catch up to the Juggernaut and strike him in the back with his hammer. Thor knows that somewhere far away, his father Odin is fighting for his life, so he needs to get rid of Juggernaut as fast as possible. With all his strength, Thor gives Juggernaut one strong swipe with his hammer, but Juggernaut does not fall, and Thor gets caught in his grip again. He can feel the life getting squeezed out of him. Then we see two beings appear as they watch these two down below. It is Bedlam and Conquest. They separate Thor from Juggernaut with relative ease. Thor's mind is filled with indescribable sensations. And what kind of power do these two beings possess? Then they disappear while taking the Juggernaut with them. And Thor is left wondering, wherever they go, the three of them will be great danger to anyone. That's the only encounter Thor has with Juggernaut in the Eighth Day saga. Now let's go to another story. This one is in Thor, God of Thunder Reborn. And just like the last story, his encounter with Juggernaut this time is also kind of short. But here's how it goes. Thor is somewhere in Thailand, holding some relic he acquired. He's running away from some demon-worshipping cannibals. Thor reaches the end of a cliff with nowhere to run. One of the men behind him says that Thor cannot fly without his hammer, and even calls him a false god that has entered the temple of the one true Rage Father. Thor pulls out his axe, ready to fight off the cannibals, but they tell him they will not be the ones to fight him. That honor will go to the Sitarak's champion. The one to challenge Thor will be the unstoppable Juggernaut, again. The sheer size of Juggernaut in this comic shows just how small Thor really is compared to him. Since he became Sidorak's champion on Earth again, he's become more powerful than ever, especially when he's standing within this temple. He is now the ultimate Juggernaut. Thor says the Warlock's Eye belongs in Asgard. He's come here to take it back. The priests have told Juggernaut that the Eye is a powerful artifact, which he wants to use to conquer the whole world. Thor tries to explain something, but before he can speak anymore, Juggernaut throws a mighty punch at him, sending Thor falling down a pit. He takes the Eye and starts walking away. Thor ends up getting his hammer and flies out of the pit, calling upon thunder as he ascends, spinning his hammer, ready to strike at Juggernaut. But when he does strike, the hammer breaks apart when it hits Juggernaut. The exchange blows back and forth, but Juggernaut seems to not be affected at all. He gets the upper hand, grabs Thor, and smashes him to the ground. Then, out of nowhere, a large number of weapons fall from above. They fill the area around Thor. As some cannibals try to reach for one, a bolt of lightning emits all around them, shocking everyone. He picks up one hammer and gives a mighty blow to Juggernaut as he screams out, "My name is Thor." He uses this time to escape while taking the Warlock's Eye with him. And that's pretty much the entire battle between those two characters in that story. Yeah, it's pretty short, but Thor accomplished his mission in the end. The rest of the story does not include these two characters fighting again. But that's it. That covers a few stories of when Thor fought against the Juggernaut in the comic books. If you want to see more videos like this, then subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.